I practiced civil litigation at Adair Barristers, and I came into civil litigation without any particular eureka moment or without any really any careful consideration. Somehow I just knew from about the third day of law school that that's what I wanted to practice. And I was hooked right from the start. I was very fortunate to be able to start my career at Davies Ward, which is one of the leading corporate firms in the country, but has a great litigation group, and they were very generous and gave me the chance to practice exclusively in litigation when I started there. And it's been something I've been hugely passionate about ever since. I think what's important about my practice and the way I approach it is two qualities. The first is sound judgment. And the second is passion. And what I mean by judgment is that, to my mind at least, what your clients are paying you for in a litigation practice is exercising great judgment. They are paying you for the advice about what steps to take, when to litigate or not litigate, and what steps to take in the course of the litigation. And all the advocacy skills in the world aren't going to help you very much if you've made poor decisions at the outset. So I think that sound judgment is very important and beneficial to my clients. And I also think that the passion that I bring to my practice is beneficial to my clients. Litigation is something that I am hugely committed to. It's a love of mine, and I hope my clients know that I'm lying awake at night worrying about their problems, and I care deeply about learning about the law and taking what I've learned and applying that to their problems. The best example of teamwork that I have in my practice is when we actually opened our firm, Adair Barristers, about a year ago. There are five lawyers at our firm, and we came from a larger firm that had established systems and an infrastructure and management in place. And we went into a new space for us where we only had just the five of us and our support staff. And it took a tremendous, tremendous team effort, much more, I think, than any of us ever anticipated, to get the new firm up and running and to make it work in a way that worked for us and for our clients and for everybody who participated in that project. And I have to say, I was really proud of everybody in our office, from top all the way down to the bottom, for the commitment that they showed, the willingness to do anything, whether it was moving and unpacking boxes or pouring water or anything else that had to be done, as we were figuring out who was going to do all the things that had to be done to make us successful. It really was an example of everyone chipping in with work that they might not be used to doing. I've been very fortunate in my career in that I've sort of always followed my gut about where to go and where to take my practice. And I, as I say, I've been very fortunate because I've been exposed to some wonderful mentors. I started clerking for the judges of a court of appeal. And I was very lucky to have that experience because I was able to learn from them how to think critically about the cases, but also how to always have a view to the fairness of the outcome. I then practiced for a while at Davies Ward, and I was able to learn from Kent Thompson and Sandra Forbes and the rest of the team there. And I really took away from that what tremendous dedication and commitment they have to their clients and to their files, and that you never ever quit until you've done everything you can to help your clients succeed. I then was able to spend some time working for Paul Pape, who really was amazing in the sense of teaching me the one thing that I think Paul does better than anybody else that I've been exposed to is figuring out what really happened between two people. And Paul would never put the case out of his mind until he understood what he thought had really happened. And then everything he did flowed from that. Community and pro bono work, to my mind, is hugely important, particularly for lawyers, because it's what separates us out as a self-regulating profession rather than just a profit-generating business. Not to say, of course, we don't care about running a business. We do, but we have a community service function that goes beyond that. And we can achieve that, I think, through pro bono work, through community involvement, and other efforts like that. So, for example, when a women's shelter in Toronto called me one day, had been referred through a friend of mine for some advice with an employment matter that they were facing and to handle the litigation side of that. You know, you have a choice at that point as to whether or not you're going to bill them for your time. And of course, they expected to be billed for their time. They knew they were calling a lawyer. And you have to think to yourself, is this the best use of this shelter's money to pay me to do the work or not?